Brett Okamoto here with Kevin Holland. Here, UFC, what are we on here? 307, the Noche thing threw me off. Yeah. We were calling it Noche. UFC 307 in Salt Lake City. I ask you this every time we go to these new places. You seem to find some fun. It's a decent time during fight week. This is a 185 fight week, so not too much weight cutting. What are you doing for fun this week?
We got coyote hunting on Thursday, so that'd be pretty cool. And then some shopping today. And then do a little workout in the mountains, you know, some rocky stuff, you know what I mean? So none too crazy.
I don't know, coyote hunting on fight week sounds a little crazy, right?
It'll be fun. I get my new bolt action, so I'm pretty excited about that. Uh-huh. It's Wook, so it has the wood furniture and stuff. It looks pretty clean.
Are you more excited to go coyote hunting on Thursday or fight Roman Dolice on Saturday?
I'm excited to fight, you know what I mean? I'm always excited to get paid, but I'm probably more excited to go coyote hunting in Utah.
Let's talk about how this fight came together. It's always kind of interesting with you, and it seems like it's kind of the same process, right? They call and you say yes. But with this one in particular, I guess I wasn't maybe personally expecting this type of matchup. What were you expecting after the last
one? I thought it was going to be Chris Curtis. You know what I mean? It's like that's what it was looking like. Mm-hmm. And he tore something, you know what I mean? And so, you know, now I'm over here with Roman. And either way, it really doesn't make a difference. They're both from pretty much the same camp. So overall, one does one a little bit better than the other, and the other does this a little bit better than the other. Overall, they do the same. They throw big punches and get hit in the face.
I feel like, you know, you always kind of say it doesn't really matter. At this point in your career, but you fought, you know, anybody and everybody, who would make a difference? Like, if you got a phone, if you got the name and it came through and you're like, oh, dang, that name. Like, are there names like that for you?
Nah, I don't think so. At the end of the day, a fight's a fight. I fought heavy hitters. I fought good grapplers. I fought, you know, guys like Wonderboy who was very slick. You know what I mean? So I fought everybody. And at the end of the day, none of them really hit that hard. None of them are really that dangerous, you know? So, and there's a ref standing like a couple feet away. It's not that bad.
Who do you feel like is the best guy you've ever fought?
Best guy I ever fought? Probably was Wonderboy. You know, like overall, like best guy as far as like striking goes. And then, like, best overall guy, and probably Marvin. Marvin was pretty complete. Mm-hmm. Striking wasn't that good, but he was a complete mixed martial artist. I mean, but overall, they all do the same. They either look to hug you or they're really good strikers.
What do you expect out of Roman? Is he going to hug you or is he going to stand with you? What kind of fight do you expect?
It's like my striking hasn't been looking that great on paper lately, so he might try and stand for a little while and get sniped a couple of times because he's slow. You know what I mean? And then he'll start to hug. All the 85ers love to hug.
What makes you say that your striking hasn't looked good on paper?
I lost to Wonderboy, right? Then we went out and we got, two wins because I had broke the hand. So we beat the dude with the left hook. That looked nice. Then mm-hmm. we beat Chiesa. That looked nice. But anybody can beat Chiesa striking, right? So that doesn't look that great. And then I go off and I fight JDM, lose to JDM. That's a striking battle. Lose the MVP. That's a striking battle. And then that last guy, he caught me on one leg, so it looked like I got dropped. So mm-hmm. technically, on paper, I'm not the best striker right now. Mm-hmm. So hopefully Roman goes out there and gives that a chance, and, you know, I beat the brakes off him.
Well, that's just looking at results. Do you feel like, for whatever reason, your striking hasn't been up to where it should be, or do you just feel like that was just the results and your actual performances were not maybe indicative
of
that?
I think somebody was smoking rocks on the JDM fight. I think on the MVP fight, you know, it's like when a guy runs that good, my corner should have threw a banana peel inside the ring, and hopefully he would have slipped on the third round. And then the last fight, guy catching me on one leg. I mean, dude hits kind of hard. So he caught me on one leg. Didn't hurt, just caught me on one leg. So.
You know, I usually don't talk to you about titles and rankings because I know it doesn't really mean much to you. But this one is, I do want to ask you about it because you're facing the number 10 guy. And a lot of guys want to face the number 10 guy. They're like, oh, I want to get in the top 10. I want to get in the top 10. You get it. Mm-hmm. And obviously you have a track record and you have a resume. But I think it's also because of your popularity, your entertaining fighting style. When you get an opportunity like that, you still don't think about it at all, or you're like, this could open the door to some things?
Nah, normally I slack off when they give me a top guy. I'm like, all right, I fight this guy, I'm going to get a lot of money, and then I just go back to fighting bums after if I lose. But this time it's like there's a couple people I don't mind beating the crap out of. I'm not saying he's one of the guys, but he's connected to one of the guys. So therefore, you get the job done, then I might get to one of the guys.
Which guy is that?
Yeah, we'll keep it in the archive. They know who it is.
Is he ranked in the top 10?
They know who it is.
Okay.
They know.
You know, I got a few names that are in there because, again, I look at the rankings and I'm like, man, Kevin gets this fight. By the way, you're favored to win it. Paulo Costa. And actually, in my research, I found in 2021, you told South China Post that Paulo Costa's problem is that he sucks. Do you remember saying that?
He does kind of suck. Yeah, he's like lackluster, you know what I mean? It's like a fun guy, fights really fun, can do some great things when he wants to. Just half the time he shows up and he doesn't want to. Ever since the Izzy fight, just kind of, you know. And it happens. People go downhill sometimes.
Do you always want to? Do you always want to be in there?
I always want to fight. Yeah. I don't care who it is. Yeah. I really don't care who it is.
You've never had a night where you're like walking in and you're like, I'm not feeling it this time?
You know what? MVP fight. I was walking in, I was like, this guy's not even a UFC guy. He should have stayed with PFL and Bellator. But overall, once that cage locks, I'm like, all right, well, let's get it.
Yeah. Well, Paulo Costa sounds like a fun fight to me. What would you think about that fight? Would you want that fight if it got offered after this one? Because I could see that happening.
It wouldn't matter. I mean, short arms, you know, not the fastest guy. Big guy, looks good. Great for the camera, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, don't let your daughter put a poster of him up in the room, you know what I mean? But fighting-wise, I'm not worried about him. I'm not really worried about anybody when it comes to a fist fight.
Yeah. What about Izzy? Would that one interest you? I mean, that's realistic as well, right? The guy's coming off of a loss, and he was the champion for such a long time. Would you want that fight? Would that get you excited?
I mean, not really. I mean, it would have been excited if beating him as a champ. Now he's just some guy who can't stop running backwards and getting clipped and throwing a lot of leg kicks. I mean, it's like, at the end of the day, it's like some guys fighting like that, they play the chess match where they're just like doing this all night. And it's like, that's boring. It's like, you know, I'd rather fight Paulo Costa than fight Izzy. You know what I mean? Because at least Paulo's going to come out there and fight when he actually wants to fight. Izzy's going to go out there and all night, and I ain't got time for that.
That makes sense.
I mean, if he wants to scrap, we can scrap. It doesn't matter who it is.
That makes sense.
Figure out something.
And I got to get your opinion on Dracus. You know, everybody's talking about just how ugly he fights, like to know
he's
what you would like to think about that.
He's always a fun fight because he fights. You know what I mean? It's like he goes out there and he's having a real fist fight. He's throwing these sloppy, crazy punches. He's rushing at you. He's there to fight. I feel like he's beating up a lot of guys. A lot of guys have never been in a real fist fight. You know what I mean? So he's making it a real fist fight. You know, and it's like even when he's tired, he's still just grinding and coming at you. And those guys who've never been in a real fist fight, they're like, oh, he's coming at me. He's coming at me. He's coming at me. Yeah. So, yeah, you can't play that little game when a guy's coming at you like that. So
What percentage of guys in the UFC right now want to get in a fist fight? Like, what would you set that number at that really want to just throw down like you were describing?
Anybody from the back order, they're down to get in a fist fight. These new guys, I mean, they just want to play the point game, you know what I mean? Get paid, get a belt, and say they did MMA so they can get more girls. I'm going to get girls regardless, and I'm going to have fun regardless, so it don't really matter.
You think, last thing, you think you can draw a fist fight out of this guy? Can we see a Kevin Holland-type fight out of Roman Dolidze, or do you think he's going to really try to avoid it on Saturday?
I don't think he has a choice. I think he has to fist fight me. Yeah, it's like if I'm correct, his wrestling is not the best, but his grappling's pretty good. You know what I mean? If I'm correct, his striking's not that pretty good. So overall, I just feel like he's going to have a fist fight with me.